Hello everybody, it's Kim here, and in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to merge your projects in Storyboard Pro. Now in the previous videos, we looked at splitting and extracting your projects so that you could save them into separate files so that more than one person could work on the same storyboard at the same time. Now we're going to merge those projects back together. So in this case, this is after everything's been approved on your side, everything's been approved on the other person's side, and now you want to bring those projects back together into one big storyboard again, like it was when you started, but now with all of the edits that have been done on the storyboards. So I've got the first half of the storyboard that we had when we split the storyboard in the first place. So as you can see, there is a whole bunch of storyboard that should be here that was split and removed from the file. So we're going to now merge that last half back in here. I'm going to go to File, Project Management, and I'm going to say Merge. And you're going to get this dialog box popping up. At the moment, you can see the one that we have open currently, which is the V1301, meaning it's the first part of the storyboard. Now we want to add the project that we want to merge into the storyboard. So I'm going to say import project, and I'm going to look for the second part of the storyboard, the part that I split in the first place. I'm going to select that storyboard file, and now you'll see that it pops up here in our project box, and you'll see some options down the side here. For instance, remove project, which means that if you've imported the wrong project, you can remove this. And also move up and move down. If I move this up, you'll see that it takes the place of the first file that I have, in other words, the current file. What this is going to do is it's going to merge the project with this sequence in front instead of behind the sequence that we currently have. We don't want it to work that way, so we're going to move this down back to where it was, because we want this to remain the first half of the storyboard, and we want the new piece that we're bringing in or merging to actually pop up after these panels. So this just changes the order in which your storyboard merges. And then of course you can also see how many sequences you have in each of these projects. We have one sequence, and it's going to remain one sequence all the way through because this is a storyboard of one act. And this would just refer to which is your first sequence and which is your last if you had more than one. The duration of each of those projects and the order. And as I mentioned before, we want this one to be in number one and this one to be in number two. Otherwise, you can change the order by moving your sequences around. So now we're going to look at this dialog box down here. So this dialog box basically allows you to have some control over the captions of the project you're going to be merging in. In this case, we have all of these captions matching. So we have dialogue next to dialogue, action next to action notes, slugging next to slugging, notes next to notes. What you can do is you can either remove these captions from the part that's being merged into this file. In other words, it'll remove all of the dialogue from that project that's being merged in. And you can do that by pressing remove caption. You'll get a strike through that option. If you decide to change your mind, bring the dialogue back, you can then add the caption. Then you get the option again to move up or move down. If I move my dialogue down, what is going to happen is it's going to replace whatever is in the action notes and put those into the dialogue notes. So this just gives you a little bit of control over any changes that you want to make with your captions as your storyboard comes in. In this case, we don't really want to change anything, so I am just going to move this back up to where the dialogue is. I want my dialogue captions to remain in dialogue and the rest of these to remain where they are. Then over here, we get some little check boxes for sequence renaming and for scene renaming. Now what Storyboard will automatically do is it will update the numbering of your panels and scenes and sequences so that there aren't any conflicting numbers in your storyboard. But this just gives you the option to rename those panels to exactly what you want them to be. So you would tick your sequence naming or your scene renaming, depending on what you want to rename. And then you would start it at whichever number you wanted to use. This just helps when you've added quite a few scenes or maybe sequences to your storyboard project. And when you're merging it in with another storyboard, you might have to change some of the numbers on the scenes to fit in with the project that you're merging it to. In this case, again, because we split from the storyboard before, the scenes and panels should all be named correctly as is. Then we have use project name as sequences prefix. So this will just rename all of the sequences with the project name in front of the number. Then we have create new soundtracks. In this case, it just means that whatever storyboard you bring in, if it has any soundtracks, it's going to add new soundtracks underneath rather than adding it to the existing soundtracks that we already have. I'm going to leave it because I don't mind my sound being added to these soundtracks that already exist, but the option is there if you want it. So now I'm ready to merge my storyboard and I'm going to say okay. Merge successfully completed by Storyboard Pro. We say okay, and now you'll see that that half that we split earlier on is back in our project. It's all there. It's got any notes that were originally put in the dialogue because I asked for it to keep the captions in the dialogue box rather than putting the dialogue in the action notes or the slugging, for instance. It's put all of our soundtracks on the same tracks as the earlier piece of our storyboard that we were merging it to rather than putting these on new soundtracks. And it's basically done everything we've asked it to do. So now we have this one file that we can save and export for approval or for any other changes that we might want to make. And that's how you merge a project in Storyboard Pro. Join us in the next video to learn how to insert scenes into a Storyboard Pro project.